what I can only describe a very lightning talk on tales of the not-so-successful DevOps. Short session. My name is Debbie Wren. I'm an Agile coach with JP Morgan. And our talk today is really some of our experiences around bridging the gap between development and operations.
And I'm Ashish Medirata. I'm also an Agile coach in JP Morgan. So we kind of collated all our experience and whatever we've seen in the firm and trying to bring together in this condensed form for you guys today. Hopefully, you can take something from us.
So, when we look at Agile and we look across the years, the message that's come across loud and clear is the promise of agility. The promise of agility, better, faster, cheaper, happier. All four dimensions, which most organizations, when they're looking at improving and closing the gap between the various parts of the organization that are trying to deliver software, are all aspiring to these various elements.
Yep. As we talk about the promise of agility, right, but you have to talk about, and the session is focusing on the DevOps state today, right? So what is the state of DevOps? It's a long journey. It's a long road, right? All of us are on that journey. Some are far ahead, some are a little behind, and some are still even to get started, right? And we all understand that there are many challenges, and we are still all figuring out our solutions. So hopefully, some of the things we'll talk about next will help you understand our perspective, and maybe you can relate to them. Yeah. So some of the challenges that we have seen are how are the teams structured today, right? From purely a structural point of view, so you'll have mostly the build teams, which is your Scrum teams, right, or feature teams, and then you have your ops team, which are completely separate, right? They are like in two different worlds. They don't look eye to eye. They don't see each other, right? They don't talk to each other. So it's the separation boundaries are today, in the sense, you really don't even know sometimes who's my ops guy, who's actually deploying my code. So those are some of the ways or the challenges which are there right now for us, right? The teams are not just separated by distance, but they're also separated by the fact the way they work, right? So there is, from the build side of the world, there is, we gotta roll out these features every 2 weeks. We have this chunk of functionality coming every 2 weeks or whatever your cycle is, right? And then the ops guys are, hold on. I gotta keep my system stable, right? I can't take every 2 weeks, I can't take things, right? So that whole mindset is in a conflict, right? So you have one folk throwing things on the other side of the wall, and the other guy saying, I can't take it. It's because I have to support the customers, I have to make sure whatever you're throwing doesn't bring the system down. And so I have my own ways, my own policies, my own rules set for me, while this other side of the fence, you have this now whole movement where we are saying, yeah, we can deliver whenever we want, right? Then, sometimes in organizations like us, we have not just few choices, but large choices, right? So now we have so many groups, so many programs, and at varying levels of complexity and different technologies. So you're actually spoiled there in the sense that which ones are the right ones to use, which ones are the right ones you want to take forward, maybe based on your technology roadmap or your strategy. And then there are the ones which probably they are gaining traction, but you really haven't vetted them out, right? So maybe, and then there are some you want to drop completely. The other key challenge is about transparency, right? So transparency is about how much can I see what's happening in the ops world, and how much can I see what's happening in my build team, right? Can the ops guys look across the wall? Can the dev guys look across the wall? So again, the transparency both on the upstream, downstream systems is extremely low in many cases, many projects. And all this comes back to the culture or the fact that how much do you trust the other one, the other team? Yeah. So let's when we ask this question to teens, and they're like, yeah, we've seen some of them. I'm sure everybody in this room, anybody seen any of these challenges? Raise your hand. Yep. All right. So what we've seen is that although they've seen the challenge, when you ask them, what are you going to do about it? Are you doing something about it even? Are you thinking about changing anything? And they say, no, we're too busy. We don't have the luxury. I got my delivery pressure to do. I got to install this latest, greatest patch, and I can't go and look at how I'm going to look for this longer term thing. I just don't have the bandwidth, right? So those are the ways we have found teams working out in various programs. Yeah. So some of the things that we have tried, and I'll talk a bit about that in our solution, is we are trying to break that wall, basically. So when we said there's a wall in the dev side and the ops side, you want to drill a hole through that wall so that people start to see each other, right? They start to see what the other person is doing, what the other team is doing, and you get that communication flowing freely, right? So it's about building your cross-functional collaboration between the two silos, right? And some of the things you'll find us doing, we'll ask the teams to go and see the system. So if you are in the dev team, why don't you go and sit with the ops guys and say, how are you actually doing your day-to-day work? What do you really do? When a server goes down, what do? So just by seeing that improves and brings that empathy, right? On the other side, the ops guys are also spending now time with the dev teams and saying, yeah, let's see what you guys do. So there are many things that the ops can also learn, right, from the devs. Probably like version control, how do you do automation, so many other things and other engineering techniques, right? So there's so many avenues where people can collaborate with each other, right? So we're trying to make sure that people see the system, and then you focus on the flow, which is like, I have this functionality, it flows through the system, which is I build it, and then I've got to deploy it, right? So all of us have heard of the three amigos, right? So, but I'd like to add that we have to have this fourth amigo in at least large organizations where you have this deployment person, probably part of that group, right? So you have them coming to your stand-ups or your sprint reviews, so kind of inviting and making that collaboration happen, right? Which all leads to building trust. And for all this collaboration to happen, what is the biggest roadblock? If you ask the teams, what are you being measured on, right? What is your success factor, right? And you'll find that those are conflicting really, right? There is the team which has to build the functionality, and there is a team which has to make sure things are running as smoothly as they are, and they should continue to run smoothly, right? So the key thing was to make sure that the goals are aligned, right at the top, which is, and the goals are the business metrics, right? Which is, are we meeting the business needs? Whether it's making sure you are getting more market share, whether you are making more profit margins, whatever it is, your business goal is what the overarching goal is for both the groups. So that's a key thing for you as a group to go back and say, what is our goal? Is it in conflict with this other group? And what is the commonality that we want to drive for? And usually, those are business metrics.
Yeah.
So how do you get to do that? Also, what we have seen is that teams have so many things which are working extremely well. So the ops guys will have some great utilities written down, right? And they'll have some secret cheat sheets, right? Which they only know in their team only, right? And then you'll have so many ops teams who each one of them themselves may have so many other tricks up their sleeve on how to make sure they best optimize their ability to function in that area, right? Whether it's bringing up servers, putting on new patches, and all those things, right? And similarly, on the build teams, right, you'll have, again, similar hidden gems, if I may call them, right? So what we want is, and what we've encouraged is, teams to bring that all that learning forward, right? Bring those practices forward, whether it's tooling, whether it's processes, whether it's anything else, any ideas that you are doing in your group, in your small teams, kind of build that knowledge base and have that widely shared across the whole team. And team in this case, again, is the build and the ops team. And talking about learning here, so again, key message. So like we said, so folks are now interacting, and when you interact, you learn so many new things. So the developers now realize the importance of what does it take for me to make sure that the system is reliable, it is a high availability system, what kind of log messages should I put in what kind of a format so that it can be consumed by the ops tools in a consistent format. So again, a lot of learning for developers. When I say developers, it's developer, testers, everybody on the team. And on the ops side, again, they are learning how they can influence some of those early decisions, whether it's even at an architectural or a design level, and even look at how I can then say, yeah, for us to work better, these are things we are looking for. And they pick up a lot of, like I said earlier, a lot of the engineering practices. Now, how I can manage? You've heard some talks today on infrastructure as code, right? So now they have to start learning on the ops side how I need to do version control of my infra scripts, right? Whether it's Puppet, Chef, and so on, right? And how I can then build quality into that part of my role and kind of make it more strategic rather than simply plugging network cables or changing hard disk drives, right? So again, a lot of emphasis on tooling, and tooling is key for sharing and building on each other's strength. Yeah?
So I think just to summarize some of the key takeaways, is mind the gap, close the gap, get your operations people closer to their people and vice versa, do some job swapping so people build up that appreciation and have empathy for either side.
Exactly.
One of the, obviously one of the practices from XP pairing is you can apply
Yeah, I think we mentioned that. Yeah, so we are encouraging them to do that. And also the longer term, maybe to get them embedded in the teams, if you can get to that direction.
Thank you.